Now in the next step, we are discussing.
Here, I am going to explain our project. Our project title is Design and Implementation of Multiplayer to Overcome Aging by Using Adaptive Hold Logic. We are doing this project under the guidance of Mr. K. Appalaju, sir. Next, we are discussing about our abstract. In many digital applications, we are using multipliers. Every component has a certain lifetime. If that lifetime is expired, then the degradation of components arises in every device. Due to this, manipulation is going to occur in the output data. To overcome this, there is a need of replacing that component. But by replacing that component, this is a very complex task. So here, instead of replacing a component, we are adjusting the timing violations known as delay automatically by using variable latency design technique in adaptive hold logic, so that the output data will be recorrected. In the next step, we are discussing about our block diagram. Here we are having the sub-blocks named as column bypass multiplier, razor flip-flop, and AHL block. The main multiplier operation is done in column bypass multiplier. Razor flip-flop will detect the error whether it exists or not. AHL block will correct the error. Here the aging indicator block will count the number of errors. If there is no error in the razor flip-flop, it will directly go to the product term. If there is an error in the razor flip-flop, it will again re-execute. Now next we are going to the column bypassing multiplier block. The name column bypass multiplier block is came. The multiplying operation is done column wisely. If any multiplicand bit is 0, the addition operation cannot be performed. This block is about 8-byte multiplier using 4 4x4 multipliers. Here the carry is carried from right to left, finally produced as CA3. Now let's move to razor flip flop block. In this we are having main flip flop, shadow latch, XOR gate, and 1 mux. Here the main flip flop catches the execution result with normal clock cycle. Shadow latch will catch the result with delay. If the latched bit of main flip flop and shadow latch is different, then the error bit is 1, or else it is 0. Now let's go to adaptive hold logic. AHL is used to adjust the input arrival time based on the aging indicator delay. When an input pattern arrives, both judging blocks will decide whether the pattern requires 1 cycle or 2 cycles to complete and pass both results to the multiplier. The not equal to gate and signal will become 1, and the input flip-flops will latch new data in the next cycle. Now let's move on to hold logic. The function of hold logic is XOR operation between A4 and B4 and A5 and B5. If the output of hold logic is 0, that is A4 equal to B4 or A4 equal to B5. Either the 4th or 5th adder will not produce a carry out. If the hold logic output is 1, then the current operation requires 2 cycles to complete. Here we are using VHDL language for writing the code. Now let's move on to the process for creating a project. Click on the Xilinx software. Now a window will open. Click on File and go to New Project. Give the title name of the project. Then click on Next. Click on Next. Again click on Next. And then click on our project name, select VHDL module and click on Next. Give the required inputs and outputs and select the number of bits. Click on Next. And then click on Next. Now we are taking the submodules of a project code and retrieving all the submodules to the Xilinx software.
Now we are going to see the project code. This is our project code. Here we are having a submodule like a normal multiplier, column bypass multiplier, 4x4 multiplier, 8x8 multiplier using 4x4 multiplier, delay module, a carry adder, latch, shadow latch, added reduction in multiplier, and our final code. Here I am scrolling down the entire code of our project.
This is the entire code of a project. I am doing now RTL schematic. This is our internal schematic of a project. Now go to simulation mode. Click on our project and do the behavioral simulation. After that, it will be look like this. And we are going to give the inputs. Click on the clock and select the force clock. Give the values of trailing edge and leading edge.
leading edge as 1 and trailing edge as 0, click on apply and then click on the other inputs A and B. Select the force constant and give the values and then click on apply. If we want to see in the decimal, we have to select the radix and then click on unsigned decimal. Here we are giving the inputs in binary format. Click on simulation and it is a simulation result. Here the error bit is going to 0 because the both output data and the result is same. So the error bit is 0. Close that window. Now I am internally creating a fault that is known as error. I am going to morph the value as 37,000. Means I am creating an error in the project code itself. Now see the output result. Do the same process, give the values of clock, the inputs A and B also. Click on simulation and this is the result. Here the error bit is going to 1 because the I am setting the default result as 37,000. The multiple result is never be that number. Here the 16 bits all are 1s. So the error bit is 1. Means the latch output and shadow latch output are different. So the error bit is 1. I am changed into unsigned decimal format. Now close the window, close the project. This is our total project. Now you have a clear view of a project. Thanks for watching this video. Thank you.